One of the most iconic conventions of the classical Greek art is considered to be the masks, which played an incredibly important role in the development of theater. The stories, told with tragedy, comedy, and satire, thanks to these masks, have shaped not only today's theater, but also many other aspects of our modern civilization. Firstly, they were mainly used in religious ceremonies of the celebration of the well-known Greek gods. The masks worn during those early ceremonies gained the meaning of personas, and the people who had them were viewed as transformed into the beings or persons they were trying to imitate. Later on, the masks met the art of theater. They were powerful tools that totally transformed actors in the desired roles, so that the viewers could not distinguish them from the theatrical characters they were depicting. In the instance of multiple actors of singers wearing identical masks, they were seen as a singular character. In addition, the ancient Greek masks were very useful as disguises, enabling one actor to switch to several distinct roles during one play. Most of those early masks had the forms of helmets, with face features, small openings for eyes, smaller mouths so that actors' mouths could not be seen, and ears, all enabling the artists to perform freely and to orient themselves during even complicated movement routines. Build materials were on the lighter side, usually made from organic materials like linen, animal skin, and decorated with fur and other objects. Some historians presented a theory that some masks hid a megaphone-like structure underneath, which elevated the intensity of the performers' voices and reached ears of viewers in larger open amphitheaters. The bigger amphitheaters got, the more profound, intense, and over-exaggerated facial features and expressions the masks represented, which was done so that more distant viewers could easily spot the full look of the characters and distinguish multiple actors on stage.